on the phone with us, one of the greatest fighters ever, Hall of Famer, Kelly Pavlik. Kelly, how you feeling today?
Doing good, man. Feeling good.
So first of all, did you happen to see Canelo Alvarez fight recently?
Yes, I did.
How impressed were you with Canelo? I personally was very impressed.
Oh, I'm really impressed. You know, the big thing on it is, of course, in nobody's eyes will Canelo ever do good enough. You know, Canelo is coming up from junior middleweight, actually welterweight, if you want to put it that way. He's climbed, he's fought everybody. People say, you know, fight Andrade, fight this guy. He's cleared out the middleweight division. He beat Danny Jacobs, he beat Triple G, two top guys. And no matter if he lost the first fight to Triple G or not, he beat Triple G the second fight. He fought Triple G twice, who was, at the time, the king of the middleweight. And again, he beat Danny Jacobs. He jumps up two more weight classes, a total of three weight classes to fight from his original weight where he won a title to fight a guy like Kovalev, who was a natural light heavyweight. I mean, not only does he beat Kovalev, he knocks him out. You know, he just thought, I mean, he's probably has an active fighter, is probably the second best resume in boxing right now, right? You know, who he fought up beside from Pacquiao. And I don't know. I just, you know, everybody's saying go fight these guys. You know, Andrade's a good fighter. Charlo's are good fighters, but, you know, they're not fighting. Andrade needs to worry about fighting, you know, at least once a year. So I think that's the big thing. Charlo needs to fight somebody and improve. But everybody comes down on Canelo. I thought he looked really good. I mean, he went there against super middleweight world champion and Callum Smith, and you know, a lot of people had Callum Smith winning that fight because of his size. They all changed their tone on it now, and after the fight's over, and say that, oh, we thought Canelo was going to win.
I hate when people do that, Kelly. I hate, like, be consistent. If thought someone was going to win, hey, give the other guy props, like credit, you know. Yeah.
Oh, dude, I see it on all different pages and groups and sites. I mean, people are, I think Canelo Smith's too big for Canelo. And not only does Canelo go out and beat him, I mean, he whoops him. It's not even that close fight. So, overall, my assessment was Canelo fought a fantastic fight, looked great. And that's not taking anything away from Canelo Smith or anybody else. I just think that everybody, you know, everybody should get their shit straight before they start running them out, though.
Hey, you didn't mention Benavidez and Plant, also two monsters at 68, which would be great fights for Canelo. You sparred, yeah, David. I was there.
Absolutely. And, you know, the reason why I didn't mention them guys, and I mainly mentioned middleweights, I personally, in my opinion, yeah, Canelo's dangerous at 168. He can contend with anybody. I think that his most dominant weight class right now will be 160, though, and there's still good fights to be made at 160. And like guys like Charlo and Andrade, maybe Billy Joe Saunders at super middleweight. You know, but again, when I was coming up, I'll just use me for a quick example. I had to go through, when I was supposed to be fighting Jermaine Taylor, after the Zartucci fight, they threw a guy like Edison Miranda in there. And at that time, Edison Miranda was the boogeyman of middleweights.
He was a killer. He was a monster.
And I still did. Yep. So what I'm saying, too, like, everybody wants to run their mouth and say, you know what, I should get the title fight. And, of course, everybody wants to fight Canelo right now because that's the money. But like I'm saying, Andrade, fight Charlo. You know, one or that. Or somebody fight somebody. Quit coming down on Canelo. He's fighting people, and you put yourself in that spot, you know, for it. I think, like I said, I think Andrade's a gifted, talented fighter. I think Charlo is, and I think that could be an exciting matchup. But you have to understand Canelo's point. You know, why am I going to go back down? First of all, Canelo, probably, even if he did go back down and say he beat some guys, he'll probably be called a weight class bully or something like that he's cherry-picked. He's fought, you know, twice up at the higher weight classes. Pretty much no win, but, you know, let some guys fight and let us see where they're at. Let's see who is the number one contender, you know. And I think at that stage, if Charlo and Andrade did fight, if whoever loses, I still think is in a good spot to fight for a title for one of the other titles. So it's just all up to you. Okay. Know, just a lot goes on.
Check this out, Kelly. The night before Canelo fight, Triple G fought. And they asked him in a press conference, Gennady, who's the one guy that you regret that you didn't fight your whole career that you would have loved to fight? And his answer was Kelly Pavlik. And I was very surprised to hear that. Kelly, how do you feel? How would have you done if you fought Triple G? You're in your prime, him in his prime.
Well, yeah, it would have been a great fight. It would have been fireworks. And I think anybody that knows, seen both of us fight, knows that I don't think Triple G faced somebody with a chin like mine, or my range, aside from Danny Jacobs.
Or
Danny
your power.
Jacobs. Yeah, Danny Jacobs is my height, but my power, but on top of that, my punch output. You know, I was a guy who, I believe I averaged around low 90s, high 80s, around sometimes even 100 punches a round I would throw. And I could do that for the full fight. I don't know. You never face somebody like that, you know. And Triple G could hit. Like, I don't have to get there with him. I watch fights, and I can hear his shots. And Triple G is one of them guys with those heavy hands that could change a fight in a split second. I just don't think it would have happened with me, you know. And I can say that because Miranda I put in the same category as Triple G as far as power goes.
Big puncher, yep.
Yeah, and I don't know. Again, it would be a fantastic fight. Triple G is a very skilled fighter. He places his punches. He's got power. He puts them to the body. But it would have been a hell of a fight. I think it would have been one of his tougher fights. Triple G would have been. He would look like he was in a real fight, you know, afterwards.
Would you knock him out or a decision? What do you feel?
I don't know. I can't pick that one. I say it'd be a great fight.
Okay, you know, what about
Listen, Triple G got he's got a granite chin. I can tell you this right now, it would not be an easy, it would be hard to knock him out. It really would. I think I could beat him by points. And you know what? At the same time, anything could happen in a fight like that.
One person you were supposed to fight and a fight didn't happen is Andre Ward. How would Andre Ward do against Canelo if they fought?
I think, again, now you're talking about a fight. Canelo's a fantastic fighter. Right now I got him right in my pound for pound number one.
There are some guys
that I would not disagree if they put over Canelo, but that's my opinion right now. He could fight. And I think Canelo can beat some of the super middleweights out there. Now, going back to the Benavidez, I think guys like Benavidez, guys like B-Ball and Beterbiev, I just think Canelo's his. Can only bite off, you know, what's that saying, like bite off more than you can chew, and that's where it comes, you know. Canelo's frame, he just ain't made to go much higher, not against the top guys. Benavidez, here's another guy. I mean, he's 6'3", he can fight, he can box. If I was Canelo, I would say, listen, you beat a couple guys at super middleweight, you won a world title, you could put that in your accolades and go back down to 160 and clear out that division again. And then probably walk off and retire. But Triple G, or who do you say, Canelo versus
Andre Ward?
Andre Ward, again, going back on that, Andre Ward is just too sharp. Andre Ward was a hell of a boxer and naturally too big. He's just too big for Canelo. He would get in there. Canelo could fight on the inside, don't get me wrong, and he has a hell of a body game. But I think Andre Ward. Buff him up on his side, then he would bounce back to the outside. Andre Ward was a big junior or super middleweight, so I think Andre Ward would be a little too much for Canelo. Andre Ward fights a lot like Hopkins, and they're smart. You know, they come in, they time you, they throw punches when you're getting ready to set up a combo, and they kind of cut you off on that. They, you know, hit you on the inside. They're just good fighters, and I don't think Canelo's got enough to phase Andre Ward at 168.
A couple more, and I'm done. I have to ask you this. Hall of Fame announced that Ward, congratulations to him. Klitschko, congratulations to him. And Mayweather are first-time ballot Hall of Famers. I myself would have picked James Toney over Klitschko, just because what he did in his sport from 160 to heavyweight. How did you feel about James Toney not being a first ballot Hall of Famer?
The first ballot, I don't know, but he...
Klitschko over him? I don't know.
You had some good people on that list, though.
Yeah, it was a lot. It was Cotto. It was Ricky Hatton. It was Vinny Paz.
You have some arguments. You definitely do. I kind of agree. First of all, I think Tony has been... I'm not sure on this. So I might be wrong. I believe Tony's been retired longer than Klitschko.
No. But they're both on the ballot, so...
Yeah, but still on the ballot. But still, that's why another reason why I would have kind of given it to Tony over, although... Tony fought guys, and what Tony was able to do from the weight classes to go up from middleweight to heavyweight and do what he did. It was pretty impressive. James Tony definitely belongs in there. So, but it's just one of them years, you know, Klitschko's too. They got that name now. You know, there's some people that's in the Hall of Fame right now that we all know mainly was because of a name, not so much on the boxing ability.
Yeah,
but
politics. The politics always win in the sport, unfortunately, but it is what it is. Before I end this, I want to ask you really quick, Kelly Pavlik, YouTube boxing, what did you think of Jake Paul's knockout, and how do you feel about Logan Paul and Mayweather doing an exhibition?
It's a good question. You know, listen, a lot of people don't like the fact that they're boxing, but these guys kind of take the sport pretty serious, though. They're bringing people to it. Boxing is struggling numbers-wise right now. And listen, if you get some mainstream people or crossover and get people to come to the sport to watch it, I don't see what it's hurting. I don't think any boxing people should really be mad. Now, on the flip side of that, these guys call themselves, like, contenders and stuff like that. I could get a little irritated with that. I mean, you fought an NBA player who couldn't, and you both matured in that fight. And then, what Paul's fighting Mayweather?
Logan, the older one. He's 200 pounds. He's young. He's 26, I think. Yeah. And he was an All-American wrestler. He's an athlete.
He's going to go into that fight with a big weight advantage, kind of like McGregor did against. You know, people can say what they want. McGregor was a good amount heavier than Floyd Mayweather.
Hey, Jake beats Conor. And listen, Kelly, they're from Ohio.
Yeah, I know. They didn't have a problem with them.
Yeah, so
Mayweather, though, he could have the 200 pounds. Mayweather hasn't fought now, 3 years again? But Mayweather's still going to win that fight. It's just, you know, it'd be like me saying I would go up to a UPS driver and hop in his truck and drive his route faster than him or better than him. It ain't going to happen, right? Floyd Mayweather, that's what he does. And, you know, I know they're in for the money. And listen, if he could swing it, he could get that fight like that because of his popularity. You can't really get mad at the guy either, though. He knows his worth, so.
I think we have a reality show, Kelly. We're going to go to all these people, and you're going to do their jobs for one day and see whose job can you do better. So one day you're going to do my job, one day UPS job, one day you could be a veterinarian, one day you could be anything you want, anything you ever dreamed of as a kid. And see, maybe you'll do better than a UPS guy. Maybe your driving skills are like Mikey Garcia. Maybe you could, you know, do it faster.
Shit, that wouldn't last. Everybody would be getting rid of me.
All right, there you have it. Before we end this, I want you to tell everybody about your new podcast and where can they find it and all the details.
Yeah, so it'll be on the YouTube. It'll be the Punchline. We're actually just getting going on that now. With Lorenzo's Antenna out of Dallas. We'll still have our regular Punchline, you know, that we'll be doing live. But this one will be this formatted different, and we're going to be doing more interviews, and it's just going to be kind of, you know, cooler, more with the fighters, getting them on, and people be able to hear their sides, and then of course we're trying to get you, which I'm guessing we might be able to today.
I'm down. Sign me up.
I think people love to hear the other parts of boxing. You know, we're looking forward maybe to guys like Lee Samuels and you, you know, on the other part of the sport, and what it takes and how it all works. So
yeah, no, I'm going to keep it 100. I'm going to make a lot of people angry, but that's normal.
Everybody,
the Punchline on YouTube, James Dominguez, Kelly Pavlik, don't miss it. They're giving Joe Rogan a run for the money for the best boxing sports combat podcast, because right now it's pretty much Joe Rogan, right?
Yeah, but Joe Rogan's kind of all different. He's got all kind of different topics on his. I don't know if he'd be just combat.
Well, he does do that from time to time. That's true. So, you know what? You just knocked out Joe Rogan.
Yeah. Joe Rogan, he's a good guy, though. That's my homie.
He's all right. So. Except I don't like his opinions. He blew up Ronda Rousey to unrealistic sizes. She's the greatest athlete in the history of the universe. Like, hey, pump your brakes, buddy. Like, dude, she had, Kelly, she had 6 fights in the UFC. I think her total amount of fights is 6-2. How could you be the greatest athlete? If you're a boxer and you're 6-2, you're not even winning an NABA title yet. But, yeah, you know, marketing and image and stuff. But I'm saying they overdid it with pumping her up. And then when she lost, she couldn't handle it. But that's because they set her up for that.
Yeah, she did have a hard time with that.
It's what it's how you handle stuff, and life's not easy. But nobody really teaches a fighter how to handle a loss, you know? Nobody ever brings it up and says, okay, if you don't win this fight, this is how you handle it. It's not an option.
Yeah, but a long career, though, you had some heartbreaks in the amateurs, and, you know, some fighters should, by the time in a pro career, have a loss. You should have a little bit more of an idea, though, you know? Shouldn't give an excuse for anything, so...
There you have it. Everybody, make sure to follow The Punchline on YouTube. Check out their podcast. It will be fire. For ESPNReporting.com, I'm Isaac Bragg reporting.